In this video, we're going to discuss the different sources of sales revenue for Amazon.com. So here's an excerpt from Amazon's income statement for the second quarter of 2018. Okay, so we see for the quarter ended June 30th, 2018, Amazon had $52.886 billion in sales revenue. So all these numbers are in millions. That's why this is $52.886 billion. Okay, that's not thousand, that's billion. Now, Amazon in the income statement breaks out its sales into two parts. It's got product sales and it's got service sales. And we see that product sales are actually the majority of Amazon's sales for the quarter. Okay, so we've got almost $32 billion in product sales compared to $21 billion in sales of services. So most of Amazon's sales are sales of products. But we can actually go deeper than that. If you go into the notes, we see more information where we've got six different types of sales that Amazon makes. We've got sales from online stores and physical stores, which are mostly sales of products. But then we have four different types of sales of services. We have third-party seller services. Those are commissions. So for example, if you go on Amazon.com and create an account and you sell a book, and then you have to pay a commission to Amazon, they would count that commission as revenue. They've provided a service to you. You're the third party. Okay. Now, they also get revenue from subscription services. So that would be Amazon Prime. Okay, so you buy a Prime membership, and so they recognize subscription revenue. If you give them $140 or whatever, they don't immediately recognize all the revenue up front. They'll have some unearned revenue, and then they recognize revenue throughout the period of the subscription. Then we've got Amazon Web Services, where they provide services mostly to businesses, but also to individuals, but cloud computing. So this is all cloud computing, and you'd be amazed just how many different services related to cloud computing that Amazon offers. And then we've got this other category. Other has to do with advertising. Okay, so Amazon also has some advertising revenue. So we have four different types of service revenue, and then two different types of revenue from products. Now, this isn't work out perfectly. If we see it, you add these together, these two product ones, is $31,477, but the product sales are $31,864. So these categories of here being the products and then here being the service, it's not perfect. It's not exactly 100%, but this is the main idea, right? So this is mostly products being sold. And by the way, if you're wondering why there was no physical store sales in 2017, this has to do with Whole Foods. So Amazon did not own Whole Foods during 2017. So that's what the physical stores refers to. So when they bought Whole Foods after the date of acquisition, Whole Foods had $4.3 billion in sales. Okay, so we've got the online stores where Amazon's selling Kindles and so forth. Then we've got the physical stores where we've got Whole Foods, which is now part of Amazon. Then we've got the third party, we've got the commissions from when people go on Amazon and sell something. We've got the Prime memberships, we've got Amazon Web Services and cloud computing, and then we've got advertising. How do we put those all together? Why do we care what are the different types of sales revenue? Why don't we just say, well, hey, they have $52.886 billion in sales, and then the same quarter the year before, they had just shy of $38 billion, so there was a big increase. That was like 39% increase, and I've got here's the year-over-year increase in sales for each of these types. So we got 39% increase in sales. Why do we care about breaking it out into these different things? So what I would like to do is I'd like to talk about the dependence of Amazon on each type of sales revenue. That's going to tell us, okay, what is driving most of their sales and how is that changing over time, that sales mix? And then we look at the growth of each type of sales. And I think that's going to tell us something about how Amazon is changing as a company. Okay, so I've broken out some of the information we have here already. I've broken it out. And this year-over-year growth, by the way, that's just saying that when we look at the sales from second quarter 2018 and we look at second quarter 2017, we're doing the same quarter for each year. We're not saying how did it grow, how did Amazon sales grow from Q1 to Q2, because there's effects of seasonality. We're looking at the same quarter and just last year, and then how did that change the same quarter this year? Okay, now, in terms of Amazon's dependence on different types of sales, if we think of Amazon's entire net sales for the second quarter of 2018, what are the percentages that are making up those sales? Online stores, sales of Kindles, Amazon Echo, and so forth, is the majority of Amazon's net sales. Okay, so 51%, majority of the sales comes from online stores. Now, you might be thinking, hey, that's a lot. But bear in mind that if we look at the same time last year, 63% of Amazon sales were coming from the online stores, and now it's just 51. So that's a pretty significant decrease. Okay, it went down 12 percentage points. Now, if you're thinking, well, that's because they acquired Whole Foods, and maybe that is what cut this from 63% to 51%. Well, if you look at Whole Foods, that percent of sales is just 8%. Okay, just 8%. So even if you add these two together, the online stores and the physical stores, it's just 59%, which is lower than just the online stores alone last time. So the bottom line is that Amazon is becoming less dependent on sales from its online stores, okay? So what is it becoming dependent on? Well, we'll talk about that. So let's just go through. So now the second biggest thing that they are selling is third-party seller services. Again, that's the commissions. So that's almost 20%. So that's a significant part of their sales mix. And then we've got Amazon Web Services. So the third biggest type of revenue in terms of magnitude, the share of total net sales, is Amazon Web Services. So that is significant. It's more than 10%. When we look at other, the advertising, it's only 4%. And so it's only 4%. Now, let's look at, so this is just telling us the share as we stand in the second quarter of 2018, how is Amazon's revenue broken out by these different categories? But now we want to think about the future. So this is second quarter 2018. Let's look at where Amazon is going. Let's look at year over year growth. We see, and I've got them ranked here so you can see which are the biggest ones. The other category, advertising revenue, actually had 132% growth. So when we look at the 2018 the sales, it was over $2 billion for advertising, where it had been less than $1 billion the same quarter of the year before. So it more than doubled. So this actually was the fastest growth, or the most significant growth that Amazon had was from advertising revenue. Okay. Then with subscription services was the next. So we think of as selling Prime memberships and so forth, 57% growth. And then Amazon Web Services, 49% growth. It went from $4 billion to $6 billion. So there's significant growth here. Okay, and we see that actually everything is growing. Even the online stores, which had the lowest growth of 14%, it still is growing. I mean, a lot of companies would love to have 14% growth. And that's actually, of Amazon's different types of sales, that's actually the lowest. Okay, so what does this all mean? How do we tie this together? Well, what it means is this. Is that even though online stores makes up the majority of Amazon's revenue, that is changing. This is the same quarter, this Q2 2019, it will probably not be greater than 50%. It's changing. Amazon is becoming less dependent on sales from its online stores. Doesn't mean they're losing money or anything like that, or the sales are declining. Sales are still increasing for the online stores. But Amazon is becoming more and more a provider of services. We've got advertising, we've got subscription services, we have Amazon Web Services, and then even third-party seller services, right? But if we look at the top three, these are the ones that have the highest growth rate. We think of Amazon's, their total revenue growing at 39%, right? When we look at all of, or totals, net sales growing at 39%. But the ones that are growing the most are these three, the advertising, subscriptions, and Amazon Web Services. And what now, interestingly enough, this other category, the advertising and the subscriptions, those actually combined were just 10% of Amazon's net sales in the Q2 2018. So they're not that big compared to the rest of Amazon. They're growing the fastest, but they're not the biggest share of the pie. But that could change in the future. But if we look at Amazon Web Services, which is here, it's the third ranked in terms of growth. This is spectacular growth, 49%. Amazon Web Services is also pretty large. There's over $6 billion in revenue. And it's the only one of these three that are growing really fast. It's the only one that is more than 10% of Amazon sales. So what do we take away from this? Amazon is shifting to becoming more of a service provider. Okay, Amazon is becoming more of a service provider, and the services that are being provided by Amazon, they're growing at just unbelievable rates. Okay, they're growing very rapidly, and Amazon Web Services in particular makes up a non-trivial part of Amazon's revenue. You might look at other and say, okay, yeah, it's great that their advertising revenue grew by 132%, but hey, it went from a little less than $1 billion to $2 billion, and we're talking about a company that did $53 billion almost in revenue during that quarter. So you might say, what's, you know, $2 billion is nice, but it's not a huge share. That's true. It's just a small amount. But Amazon Web Services, that is substantial. It's more than 10%, and they provide a lot of services. And even though they have had competition from Microsoft and other companies for cloud computing services, and this is a significant part of Amazon's sales revenue, and is growing very rapidly. So what you're probably going to see in the future, when you look at the same time in the Q2 2019, 2020, we're going to see this shift, less of a dependence on sales from the online stores or the physical stores, and more revenue being driven by the provision of services, particularly Amazon Web Services.